Indian troops fire into crowds of protesters in Kashmir, and this was for the second day running. Casualties were inevitable. Rocks were thrown, tear gas fired, but also bullets, and they found their targets. They've not seen violence like this here since the early 1990s. This was meant to be a curfew, the first imposed in the Indian-administered Kashmir Valley in 13 years, but within hours the streets were filled with angry demonstrators. Thousands defiantly gathered for the funeral of one of the separatist leaders killed whilst protesting a day earlier. Sheikh Abdulaziz had been leading Muslim protesters trying to break through to Pakistan on a road closed since partition. They're shouting for freedom over and over again. These are scenes many believed and hoped they wouldn't see again here. Until the past few months, Kashmir, which both India and Pakistan lay claim to, had taken on a much more peaceful air, with tourism growing and the economy doing better. Although there'd been no long-term agreement, the Indian Prime Minister and the Pakistani President had met a number of times, with both vowing to solve the issue which has caused two wars between the countries. But Kashmir had taken a back seat of late, as both leaders came under pressure at home for different reasons. Musharraf is facing impeachment and Manmohan Singh is struggling to push through an important nuclear deal with America. The result has been this. All sparked by a dispute over land. The trouble began when the state government handed over 100 acres of land for Hindu pilgrims in May. That upset the mainly Muslim population and the situation worsened when the order was reversed. Hindu nationalists then blocked the only highway linking the Kashmir Valley to northern India, so cutting off food and fuel supplies. Now, months and years of negotiations to try to find peace here appear to have evaporated. Any destabilization in relations between the two nuclear nations will be viewed with some concern around the world. Alex Crawford, Sky News, New Delhi.